Robert Murphy. He's a professor of infectious diseases at Northwestern University Feinberg School of Medicine. Good morning, doctor.
Hey, good morning, Larry.
These cases that have been going up because of Delta, are we seeing a plateau?
It looks like Illinois and the states that are taking the strongest mitigation efforts is beginning to plateau. The states that are not doing that, of course, are still increasing significantly.
Well, let's talk about the situation in the southern states. We know that there have been issues with ICU beds, but now it seems like oxygen is becoming an issue as well in terms of supply.
Well, it's amazing. In a country as wealthy as the United States, in states as wealthy as Florida is, you know, they're running out of oxygen. I mean, this is a crisis. You know, they have a limit in the ICU beds that are available, the staff that can run those ICUs, and now oxygen. I mean, you know, it's really nothing short of pathetic.
Let's talk about Chicago Public Schools. Teachers, want a 6-foot barrier versus a 3-foot barrier. What's your assessment of how well prepared Chicago Public Schools are to handle all this?
Well, to me, it looks like they're ready. Because if you actually drill down into the data about social distancing, 3 feet and 6 feet are looked at together. And there is protection at 3 feet. There is more protection at 6 feet, but there's more protection at 20 feet. I mean, you know, we'll draw the line. But there's a very significant effect at 3 feet.
Dr. Murphy, I hate to almost even put this out here because people have been getting very sick from using this drug, but we've seen some stories of people using a drug that is used to kill worm disease, I believe, in horses because of faulty information that they have found online about the use for COVID-19. Just your thoughts on what you're seeing happening.
It's a drug called ivermectin. It's been around for a long time. It's used to treat worm disease in humans and in animals, in horses in particular. So you can buy it at veterinary supply stores. But don't forget, horses are quite large. They're much bigger than humans. And the drug is much more heavily concentrated. And there's been an outbreak of really poisoning from ivermectin in humans who are taking it. It's being pushed by anti-vaccine groups and fringe groups, similar to hydroxychloroquine was a couple months ago, if you remember that. And it has absolutely no effect. There have been study after study after study, including one that was just stopped in Canada with 1,300 people. It was stopped for, quote, futility, unquote. In other words, there's no effect of working in 1,300 people. So it's basically, you know, does not work, and it can be toxic.
All right, let's get to viewer questions. From the time of exposure to Delta, when do people experience symptoms? When are they contagious?
Yeah, so the symptoms can start as early as 2 days. That's unusual. And as long as 14 days. It's typically like 3 to 5, 6 days you get symptoms. And typically you're infectious around 3 or 4 days after the exposure.
Question. I'm 66 years old with underlying conditions. I'm fully vaccinated, but reaching my 6-month mark. What is the latest for us? Should we stick with the same vaccine? I've heard that switching vaccines gives you more protection.
The guideline is now that person should take the vaccine because they're 6 months out. Now, the vaccine that is recommended is the same vaccine that you took originally. If you cannot get that vaccine for some reason, because not all three vaccines are available everywhere in the United States, it's recommended that you take one of the mRNA vaccines. That's the Pfizer or the Moderna vaccine. You can take either one. We're not sure if mixing and matching is better. So that's not a given. So, you know, whatever you take, it's going to help you. The studies have been with the same vaccine, most of them, and you get significantly greater protection after the 6 months. Now, if your doctor says you're immunocompromised, you can take the vaccine right now. Otherwise, you wait a couple weeks until the full approval comes off.
All right, here's another question. My wife, daughter, and I are planning a visit with our family this Friday. They are all vaccinated. We are all vaccinated. We recently learned one family member tested positive for COVID last Monday. He is not experiencing any symptoms, neither is the rest of the family. As someone who is potentially high risk with type 2 diabetes, is it still safe to visit family?
No, unfortunately. So this is a breakthrough infection, but the person has no symptoms. Because the person has no symptoms, they're not severely ill, you only have to quarantine for 10 days. So it's 10 days from when that person was diagnosed, and then they can safely visit.
Dr. Murphy, thanks for your time this morning. Good to see you.
Thank you, doctor.
you. Have a good week.
Thanks, you too. If you didn't get your question answered, Dr. Murphy answers them bi-weekly on Northwestern University's Institute for Global Health.